Oh, there's no doubt. I mean, this is. I mean, a lot of really good men, first off, great coaches, and, you know, I have track records of the places that they've been as recruiters and coaches, so I agree with that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's a good thing to hear that sometimes from your head coach. So.
Fall camp, it's here, man.
Yep.
It's an exciting time.
Yeah, it is. You know, it's that time of year where, you know, you kind of kiss a wife and kids and take off to work, but it's fun. It's what we do this for. You know, get a chance to go out there and be with the players and kind of be hands-on with them and, you know, smell the grass, I guess you might say.
What are you wanting to see from your position group as camp does get underway tomorrow?
You know, obviously improvement, you know, some maturity. We've got a few young guys that are going to be in that room, some guys that have been here and have some reps behind them. But kind of taking the reins, taking year two of the defense, you know, knowing what to do, moving on and, you know, coming out of it with some good, you know, solidification of who's going to be where and how much depth we're going to have at that position.
How do you manage the young guys? Do you bounce those guys around and cross train, or you like to lock them
in? You know, typically with the young guys, we try to pair them with an older guy so that they can kind of help them along as they're out there on the field or whatnot. And you try to, you know, we get time in the summer to meet with them, you know, for the last few years. So that helps. You're with them in the meeting room. You try to feed them information. And then you give it to them in a way that you think helps them learn. So, you know, over a few days, you kind of figure that part out. But we'll move them around and experiment some as time goes as well.
In your experience, what are some of the points on a defense, especially that jump from year one to year two?
You know, I think probably the biggest thing is understanding. You know, the first year, every day is a new day until you get to the first day of the second year, no matter whether it be, you know, offense, defense, special teams, whatever. So I think our kids can anticipate a little bit of what's going to happen, which helps our young guys when they come in because they have, you know, last year you had one coach at each position. Now you may have eight coaches plus the assistant because the older guys can help. You know, kind of bring the young guys along as well.
How key is that? Do you expect Crouch to be having gone through the spring?
Oh, yeah, that'll help a lot. I mean, because he, you know, he's gone through spring, you know, with our summer meetings now. It's going to be really his third time to be exposed to a lot of the information, but it'll help him a lot. You know, and then again, that's, you know, there are a lot of stresses outside of football with school, you know, travel, the whole thing you go through in the fall, but he's, you know, it'll help him by coming in early.
Do you expect Henry to hit the ground running pretty quick? Is he pretty sharp? Or
yeah, so far, you know, most, you know, all the guys in that room, and I think a lot of it is in recruiting because you get to know guys. You try to hopefully recruit to a certain, you know, mindset of a player, but every bit I've been around him, and again, it's early, so, it, you know, you'll tell exactly how that's going to go as time goes on in fall camp.
How has Daniel kind of grown as a leader? He's a guy who talked about that a lot in the offseason, about kind of, you know, being that alpha, looking around, being the older guy now, and how has he kind of handled that role?
You know, I think he's done a really good job with it. I think you see it a lot more on the field. You know, it's hard to be a leader sometimes because that means you're the first guy to either start whatever it is or you have to confront teammates and peers. But he's done a really good job with it. I think a lot of it starts with what he does and how he handles himself and his work so he can be an example for the rest of the guys.
Yeah, is that sometimes when a guy who's maybe not naturally very loud but kind of has to assume that role, I mean, is it okay if your leader's maybe not always the most talkative guy as long as he's doing what he needs to do?
Yeah, I mean, everyone leads in their own way. You know, they have to sort of figure that out. You know, obviously you'd love to have a lot of guys that are vocal. But that's not always the case. So they just have to find their niche of how they lead. And, you know, his has been both. You know, his has been putting an arm around a young guy or going out there and confronting a guy or trying to get them going for, you know, whatever they've got going on, whether it be a workout or practice or whatnot. So,
Coach Pruitt told us that while, you know, a lot of people say this in the country, he said that he felt that Tennessee really has the best coaching staff in the country. How would you describe this coaching staff, you know, going into the second season?
You know, a lot of experience in the SEC, okay, which is one of the toughest leagues in the country. We kind of all know that. So I think that helps. You know, Coach Chaney, Coach Ansley, Coach Pruitt, you know, each one of those guys bring a different element. But then you also have good people, all right? And we've all coached, a lot of us have coached high school, which means we were school teachers. So we teach the game of football now, and I think we have some of the best teachers of the game in this building.
When do you know when a guy's got this defense? Because it's so much conceptual, it sounds like it's tough. When do you know that a guy's got it?
Well, I mean, I guess it becomes with execution. But then, you know, a lot of times it's a new language. And so, every day a new word, you know, or words are presented to them, and so you try to get ahead of it. And as they start to be able to interact and talk back and forth with you, that's when you start to know they're starting to understand kind of the concepts and the language that they're speaking now.
Are they speaking that much better this summer compared to where we were in the spring?
Yes, because, you know, last year new words would, you know, come in or terminology, and, you know, they have that blank look. Now it's like they know, so you're trying to get the young guys to understand what those words mean, and the, you know, so a lot of it's just the interaction that they're able to do and questions that they have.
With JJ, after the late arrival, the shoulder was bothering him in the spring, how important is this time for him, and kind of what are you looking for him?
Yeah,
him in the first couple weeks.
You know, obviously for every guy on the team it's important because it's that transition from summer to fall, you know, getting ready for the games to start. So he's, you know, we expect him to have a better shot because last year he did come in later than the rest. You know, and you know, he'll do what he needs to do, and you know, time will tell on that. But all our guys are going to be pushed, and they're going to be competing for starting, you know, starting jobs and playing time.
So. Shannon Reed was a guy that proved very confident at the end of spring. Yeah. You know, was he able to kind of continue that strong work in the summer? What have you kind of seen from him right before you guys started?
Yeah, you know, all the guys have done a really good job. And again, I think it's because this is the second go around. You know, the first time it's, you know, you don't know what to expect. But yeah, he's done a really good job too. You know, I know his numbers in the weight room have been up. You know, they're changing their body. The bodies are starting to grow a little more. And then in meetings, his confidence in the defense, you see that. Like I was talking about earlier, the interaction. Sometimes you're going through it with the young guys and they're saying the answer before you get to it. So you know they have a better understanding of some things he does.
Kevin, do you sense that the guys on that D-line have a hunger to kind of step up and emerge with all those snaps that are now available? Because, you know, it's one thing you'd like to think they all practice the same way all the time, but maybe sometime when playing time's on the end of the stick, it's a little different. You know, do you see it, sense anything like that from them?
You know, I mean, I think all the guys are ready to come in. You know, I think they want to show what they've done in the last, you know, year and a half that we've all been here. So I don't know that I see it from a position more than the other than the team's ready to. You know, these guys, when we gave them a couple of days off, you know, from the weight room, and they're in there in the indoor running around and, you know, working their craft, I guess you might say. So I think they're all excited to get to that point.
You talked about the second go-around for the players. What about you as a coach, you know, having these guys that you don't really have to instill that culture now? You can talk a lot more schemes and things like that.
Yeah, you know, it's good because we know those, you know, these guys a lot better now. Last year, you know, we had basically 6 months with them at this point, roughly. And, you know, so you understand how they think, how they learn, how they respond to coaching, you know, things like that. So it makes it a little, I don't want to say it's easy, but it makes it easier for us to have an opportunity to kind of, you know, get to them a little bit better, if that makes sense. And then, you know, you're in that mode now with the new guys, with the freshmen or junior college guys, so.
What's the summer been like for you as a special teams coordinator? But how's that been different?
You know, it's a little different, but for the most part, I mean, what we do as coaches, we take whatever plan we're going to do and we try to organize it and how you're going to install it. And it's just been, you know, I've always been a part of special teams for the most part. So it's just been, you know, putting in kickoff cover as opposed to, you know, flex 6 man Bronco.
Most of the defensive assistants you guys worked together last year, but Derek being new, what's that process been like meshing with him?
You know, we worked together at Alabama. I was an off-the-field role. I was in player development. He was a graduate assistant. But so he and I have known each other for, I guess it's been 8 or 9 years ago. So, you know, most all of us, I think, have had some kind of prior relationship. I think T saw him just walk in, but I think I've met him, but I didn't really know him. I said everyone else.
Kevin, in terms of kind of, you know, changing the culture a little bit, a lot of the guys on the staff have won a lot of football games and championships and all those things. How do you get players who maybe haven't been in a culture like that to understand how much the difference is, how much every day, every rep, everything counts?
You know, I mean, I think it's just the more you say and do something, the more it becomes who you are. And I think last year we were sort of the leaders to that, if that makes sense. Now it's not only us, like I said earlier, it's the players that have been here. You know, you show them, and if they don't do it the way you want it done, you let them know, here's how we do it, or we don't do it that way. You know, there's a lot of different ways. you know, heck, every time you get in and go to work every day, you may go the same way, but you have to drive it differently because the cars are in different spots. Well, it's the same way with coaching. Every day you have a plan, but your plan has to adjust as your players respond, as they learn, as you figure out what kind of personality and who they are.